Have you ever wondered who processed the water so it is clean to drink? Have you ever wondered who designed an efficient transport system to facilitate your journey daily? Have you also wondered who built all these safe structures for our living? It's all by civil engineers. Hello, I'm Anthony, Associate Professor and UG Coordinator of the Department of Civil and Environmental Engineering at HKUST. In this talk, I will introduce you what civil engineering is, some examples of exciting civil engineering works in Hong Kong, and our programs at HKUST. What is civil engineering? It is an engineering discipline that deals with the built environment, which encompasses much of what defines modern civilization we see nowadays. Civil engineers are the professions who build safe structures such as buildings, bridges, roads, tunnels, and many other types of infrastructure. In short, we engineer civilized environment for the mankind. Different from architects who mainly involve in the pre-construction phase of infrastructure, civil engineers apply science and mathematics to design the infrastructure and oversee the entire design to completion process. We make sure the design is structurally feasible and optimal, and we make the design into reality. Civil engineering covers a broad range of disciplines which engineers would need to tackle different kinds of construction challenges. Broadly speaking, we can categorize civil engineering into six disciplines. The first one is structural and material engineering. The discipline focuses primarily on the design and analysis of structures that can withstand external forces. Structural engineers are trained to design buildings or bridges following statutory provisions and ensure that they are safe and suitable for the specific usage. For example, we have many tall and slender buildings in Hong Kong. We need to carefully consider wind load and conduct simulations to assess the structural performance of the buildings. Another discipline is geotechnical engineering. Geotechnical engineers deal with soil and rock and their influences on the safety of buried infrastructure, such as piles and tunnels. For mountainous regions like Hong Kong, these engineers play a crucial role in assessing landslide risk under rainfall and designing effective systems such as barriers and retaining walls to reduce the damage to the urban cities. Environmental engineering. It covers aspects related to quality improvement for water and land, monitoring and modeling of air pollution and environmental threats associated with our ever-changing climate. Environmental engineers develop low-carbon and sustainable solutions for improving and protecting our natural environment. Water resource engineering is crucial to coastal cities like Hong Kong. If you still remember, in 2018 and 2019, we had several very strong tropical cyclones, Mangkhut and Hatoh. The storm events had seriously flooded Macau, but not Hong Kong. It is the achievement of our civil engineers who have constructed effective urban drainage systems and catchment of rainwater to prevent the city from damage and property loss due to flooding. Civil engineers also design transportation networks and systems. We do not build high-speed trains nor the cars, but plan and manage transport infrastructure that these vehicles travel on. For example, how can we direct the traffic from one tunnel to another one in the most efficient and fair way? This is an example of the problems that we try to solve. For big projects like airport and major bridges, we have hundreds or thousands of people working on construction sites. They have different names, skill sets, and tasks. System engineering studies the management of these manpower, finance, resources, etc. in infrastructural projects. Advanced digital technologies like BIM, building information modeling, and sensing technologies are adopted to aid civil engineers' design and planning. Our climate is changing and the weather is becoming more extreme. Civil engineers face new challenges to build climate-adaptive systems to combat natural hazards such as extreme rainfall, earthquake, and tsunami. We provide holistic solutions from different disciplines of civil engineering to build a livable built environment for the mankind. Nowadays, we often hear a term called smart cities. A city cannot have no buildings nor roads. Civil engineering is fundamental to developing a smart city. We are now living in a digital era. Civil engineers develop and adopt cutting-edge digital technologies and artificial intelligence in construction, making our buildings and bridges smarter, and also making our environment greener, more resilient, comfortable, and livable. After knowing some general backgrounds of civil and environmental engineering, let's take a look on what exciting civil engineering development we have and we will have in Hong Kong and our neighboring regions. This is a forecast made by the Construction Industry Council in 2019. The figure shows a clear increasing number of government investment and construction activities in the future of Hong Kong, meaning an increasing demand of workforce in the next 10 years. This is a list of 10 major infrastructural projects in Hong Kong. Some have been completed, such as the number one South Island Line. That's where the MTR station at Ocean Park was created. We have also completed the Express Rail Link and Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macau Bridge in 2018. There are a large number of exciting ongoing projects, such as Kai Tak area. New urban developments like Lok Ma Chau and Hong Shui Kiu areas are still far from completion. We have a lot more interesting projects to work on in the future. How many of you have been to Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macau Bridge? It is one of the biggest projects for Hong Kong, greatly reducing your travel time between Hong Kong, Macau, and Zhuhai. If you have a chance to pay a visit, I'm sure you'll be amazed by what civil engineers have built. The Kai Tak development area where our old airport was situated at, together with the Kwun Tong and Kowloon Bay districts, will provide 5.4 million square meters of office space and is positioned as the second central business district in Hong Kong. It will also provide many residential flats. This development plan means that there will be a lot of buildings to be designed and constructed for the project in recent years. This is a future map on how Hong Kong will look like in 2030 and beyond. The Hong Kong government is already planning for another CBD in the North Lantau Island. The government has also had a long-term vision of strategic urban development plans such as Lantau Tomorrow and the North Metropolis Development Strategy. Civil engineering industry will be boosting in the next 20 to 30 years. Now, let's talk about what our civil and environmental engineering program at HKUST will offer to prepare our students to have solid foundation in the many disciplines of civil engineering. We have two programs, civil engineering, CIVEL, and civil and environmental engineering, CIEV. Both programs have met the requirements of the four divisions of the Hong Kong Institution of Engineers, HKIE, which are CIVEL, Structural, Geotechnical, and Environmental Engineering. This means that our graduates are eligible to take part in the so-called Scheme A training, leading to a chartership and becoming a professional civil engineer. This provides a faster pathway than those who study civil engineering programs from some overseas countries. Both CIVEL and CIEV programs are designed for a four-year study. The first year will cover general engineering knowledge, and students in the second year will learn some fundamentals of civil engineering. The third year will start to cover some specialty courses in different disciplines. The program covers totally 120 credits for graduation. We are now living in a digital era. Developing foundations on data analytics and being able to apply state-of-the-art artificial intelligence in civil engineering is crucially important to address the future challenges of dealing with more complex engineering systems. We offer an extended major in AI program. Students in either CIVEL or CIEV in this extended major will be exposed to various computer science courses, effectively developing concepts, skill sets, and hands-on experiences in the applications of AI in civil engineering. Our department also offers a minor program in Smart City, which is an emerging topic both locally and internationally, and is highly relevant and important in the future of the civil engineering industry. We will provide multidisciplinary training and knowledge needed for building smart cities that are green, resilient, empowering, adaptable, and transformative. This is the program structure of our programs in HKUST. We offer courses in both fall and spring semesters. There are a number of training courses that we will provide in summer. On average, each student will take about 5 to 6 courses per semester. What is special and attractive about our program is that we require students to gain hands-on experiences by applying what has been learned from the classroom. This includes industrial training, internship, final year project, and capstone design projects. These trainings will make our students more marketable for future job hunting. This is the professional path how our graduates will become chartered engineers after graduation. If you are admitted to our program at HKUST next year in 2023, you will graduate in 2027 and can start the four-year HKIE Scheme A training. After 4 years, you can be a professional engineer chartered under HKIE. Afterwards, you can be further promoted to senior engineer, chief engineer, or even partner and director of different engineering firms. This is a table summarizing the employment situation of our graduates. So, salary. This figure is only for reference. There are fluctuations in the salary range, but overall it is attractive, and we are one of the engineering programs whose graduates earn the highest salary. Not surprising, because of the boosting industry and increasing demand of workforce. Civil engineering is a global profession. Our alumni have been involved in various exciting projects all over the world. For example, Kylie Lam has been involved in the design and construction of bird nests in Beijing and CCTV tower in Guangzhou, which was the tallest structure when it was built in China. Do you know the tallest building in the world? It is Burj Khalifa in Dubai, as you can see from this picture. Our graduate, Travel Zhong, has been involved in the design and construction of the building. Do you want to be one of them? Some quick information about the ranking. This year, HKUST is ranked 40th in the world, and our civil and environmental engineering program is ranked top 20 globally. So, our civil engineering programs, both teaching and research at the HKUST, is world leading. I hope you are convinced after the talk that civil engineering is an exciting profession and a boosting industry in the next 20 to 30 years. There are many interesting yet challenging opportunities waiting for you. If you are ready to be challenged, join our big family. If you want to know more about our programs, or if you have any further questions, please feel free to contact us. Civil engineering is not just about the things we build, it's also about the people. People with deep technical understanding and analytical skills, people who are creative and are able to communicate those ideas clearly, people who can lead and work together. We train leaders who will engineer a more civilized, smarter, and sustainable built environment for the mankind. We hope you will join us to help build the future, yours and ours.